If you have dry eyes, it can feel like no makeup will ever work for you. Some cause irritation, they worsen your symptoms, clog your glands and tear ducts, and some even have irritants in them like arsenic, nickel, and lead. But I'm here to give you hope. I want you to know that you're not alone in your mission of self-care. It is possible to safely care for your eyes, to lessen your dry eye symptoms, and to use excellent makeup and skincare products which will not worsen your dry eye syndrome. Welcome back to Eye School with me, Dr. D, where I teach you about products and treatments related to dry eye syndrome and eye beauty so you can have healthy, beautiful, comfortable eyes. Give a little love tap on that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the latest eye tips and tricks I have for you. So first, let's talk a little bit about how eye makeup can actually lead to dry eye syndrome. The surface of your eye is covered by a nourishing layer of tears composed of mucus, oil, and water. The production and turnover of the tear film helps keep our eyes feel comfortable as well as see clearly. When you wear eye makeup, especially powder or glitters, those loose particles in the makeup can cause the tear film to break down and evaporate too quickly, leaving your eyes feeling dry and irritated. This usually occurs within 30 minutes of applying your makeup. Now, eye makeup can also exacerbate symptoms in people who already have dry eye syndrome, or it can trigger dry eye syndrome in people who don't already have it. And that's why it's important to apply your eye makeup in a way that will lessen your symptoms and support a healthy tear film. So here are some practical eye makeup tips for you if you have dry eye syndrome. So consider applying a lubricating eye drop to each eye about 30 minutes prior to doing your makeup. You can do that after you've washed your face and applied your SPF. Go ahead and throw lubricating eye drops in before you're going to be doing any eye makeup. Next, keep in mind you never want to apply your eye makeup when your eyes are irritated or red. You want to disinfect your applicators before each use to avoid contamination. Apply makeup products to the outside of your eyelashes. You want to avoid lining the inner rim of your lashes as this area is very close to the tear film. People will call this the waterline or they'll call it tight lining, and this is absolutely a no-no in my book as an eye doctor, as a dry eye specialist. We want to avoid this area. Make sure to use a minimal amount of mascara or curl your lashes without mascara for a lifted effect. And keep in mind that mascara has the shortest shelf life of all makeup products and should be tossed out every 2 to 3 months after opening to avoid eye infection or clogging your meibomian glands in your eyelids. When possible, choose cream-based products and avoid anything containing glitter, even glitter promoted as eye safe. Never share your eye makeup with anyone because you'll be sharing more than your eye makeup. You'll be sharing your critters and bugs as well. And be diligent about thoroughly removing your makeup at the end of every day. And this is probably the most important tip I could ever give you. Being diligent about removing your makeup at the end of every day can really, really make a difference with the comfort of your eyes and your dry eye symptoms. With the right care, wearing eye makeup with dry eye syndrome is possible. And if your eyes have been giving you any trouble, we can help. Okay, so now it's gonna be time for a commercial break from 2020 Beauty. I'm going to reapply my lipstick and be right back. It just makes sense to get your eye makeup from an eye doctor. Many mascara formulas contain ingredients that harm the eyes. New Clean Sweep Mascara is ophthalmologist founded and tested. It has clean ingredients. It's paraben-free, contact lens safe, and safe for sensitive eyes. One of the ingredients I love in this formulation is hyaluronic acid. Clean Sweep Mascara is free from glitter, loose mineral powders, prostaglandins, fragrance, argireline, acetylhexapeptide 3 and 8, BAK, carbon black, and beeswax. 2020 Beauty also carries eyeliner, lash serum, eyeshadow that are all eye friendly. All right, I'm back and I'm ready to talk about what products to use when you have dry eye. Because some products are better for dry eye than others. And when you're shopping for makeup, here are some things to consider choosing. Number one, cream eyeshadow and foundation. The particles in powder foundation and particle on eye shadow can irritate your eyes. And as an eye doctor, what tripped me up there was thinking about all the tear films I've seen with literally powder foundation and eyeshadow floating through it. So this is a real thing. The powdered eyeshadows and foundations will end up inside of your tear film or in your tear film. So choose cream eyeshadows and foundation whenever possible. The second tip is to go for hypoallergenic. Now it's important to remember that hypoallergenic doesn't mean you won't be allergic, but in general, it is better to go for those hypoallergenic formulas because those companies may have made it less likely that you're gonna have irritants like arsenic, nickel, lead, the major irritants. You may still be sensitive to something in those formulations, but it's less likely. Next, makeup with low water content. So most liquid makeup has a preservative that can irritate your eyes. So it is better to go with compact creams, lower water content. Regular mascara. So two-step mascara with a base and a top coat tends to flake and fall into your eyes. And in addition, waterproof mascara is not recommended. And I actually made an entire video about that, which I will link here because it's too much to go over. And if you still have problems and you seem to have tried everything, give your eyes a rest and instead highlight your eyebrows, your cheeks, and your lips instead, and see what your eye specialist has to say about some makeups that might help you. And then I want to go over how to remove makeup because that is a very important step in wearing makeup. It is important to clean your face every night. Sleeping in makeup can clog glands and tear ducts, leading to irritation. You should use a makeup remover that's oil and paraben free. Stay away from products with mineral oils, sodium lauryl sulfate, and diazolinidyl urea. It's not good apparently. I'm gonna put it on the screen because I can't say it. Consider using an eye doctor recommended lid scrub. I have many I've talked about on this channel. I love the hydrate versions. I love the one by We Love Eyes. There's a great one by Eyes Are the Story, and I will make sure to link some of my favorite lid scrubs down below. You wanna rinse well with water, and that's about it. Just make sure you get your makeup off. I personally use water and a makeup eraser, and that does really, really well for me. And in addition, I want you to know about a new EyeSafe beauty community I've just launched on Facebook. I'm gonna leave the link below to join. It's a place for patients and doctors alike to join in and talk about EyeSafe beauty. And what works for you, what works for everybody, we can share ideas together. Recently, 2020 Beauty and Eyes Are the Story have come out with some eye-friendly formulations. So in conclusion, to answer the question that this video was all about, what is the best makeup for dry eyes? Take into account all of the tips I've given you throughout this video, but my vote is for brands that are designed with eye safety in mind, like both Eyes Are the Story and 2020. For dry and even sensitive eyes, these brands to me are far ahead of the crowd. However, there's other brands with eye safe formulations, and I'd encourage you to check out my eye safe makeup free download for more information. And if you have made it this far and you're not already subscribed to my channel, please hit that button in the bell so you don't miss any notifications. That's gonna be it for today's iSchool class is over.